je comprends rien.
Gentlemen, this is going to be a match that's going to be talked about. Chris Onyx has a big fight field against Jackson Stone, Shogun.
Boy, I told you once, I say it again. Cashing here to represent Chris Onyx, about to put an end to the suplex Shogun here and show Butchie B that he picked the weakest poison.
Chris Onyx is not a small guy by any means, but that shows you how massive Jackson Stone is when he dwarfs, he shadows.
Crowd here at LC3 hot for Jackson Stone right off the rip.
Well, let's not forget to mention that man, Chris Onyx, has a victory over the Ultra Star, Ash Today, who is a former Mega World Champ. But so is Shogun, who's the longest reigning Mega World Champ here in this very company.
Josh is right. Onyx got the victory over Ashley. It was a clean victory. It was no cash ink involved. It was a clean victory.
What television monitor are you watching?
Cash ink was not involved in that Ashley Day match.
They were completely involved in that match. Both men lock up, and again, Onyx is not a weak individual, but I don't think he wants to go toe-to-toe with Jackson Stone. What do you guys think?
It's like having a death wish. You're gonna wish to be put in a body bag? Or you stand up and take on that man right there, Shogun.
We talk about it on Turmoil every week. Chris Onyx has an MMA background.
Oh, to be overlooked. She looks like one!
Now, you know, Ken might have some PTSD by getting a suplex by Jackson Stone, because 2 years ago, Shogun gave Ken a suplex, and I'm hoping Ken gets another suplex.
Why would you wish that upon Ken Mazur?
Listen, Ken has...
Ken brings his delicious graham jam and strawberry and jelly and peanut butter sandwiches.
Listen, Ken has been a thorn on my backside since I got here at Mega Championship Wrestling. So, listen...
It's because you're disrespectful sometimes, Jonai.
I'm always nice to you on your...
To me? That's to me? Maybe you're disrespectful to Ken.
Now, real quick, I actually have wrestled one match before in a different promotion, different city. But I can guarantee you, the chop is the most painful wrestling move. I mean, it hurts worse than slam. Chops are no joke. And there's a second one.
I will agree with you, James, on that 110%. A couple weeks ago, pre-turmoil, we were letting everybody know we had a mega wheel. Stuff was going on crazy. We had a random masked referee show up and chop me during the pre-tape. during the pre-interview.
Jackson trying to get Onyx up for check. Onyx doesn't want to get suplex again. He holds on his ropes in the high poke.
Get him
off
there.
The knee. He takes the big man off his feet. That's a smart game plan.
If you saw what just happened earlier, you just saw this stop by Shogun. Onyx moved out the way, and now Chris Onyx has a target.
Chopping him down. Chopping those big legs down.
No, you're exactly right, Mike, because it doesn't matter how big a strain you are, you can't get up off your knees, you're going
to
be in trouble.
And he can't, if he takes the legs out, he won't be able to do the one thing that his namesake claims him to be, and that's suplex Chris Onyx tonight.
As painful this is for the same for me, Chris Onyx has never been pinned nor submitted here in Mega in one-on-one competition.
That's right, because he's the killer instinct in him. And the management of Kenvasion. Cash Inc's got it going on, Josh.
Now, okay, so Mike, right there, if you saw the same thing Josh and I did, Onyx was cheating by wrapping Shogun's leg around that bottom rope. You did see it.
Did the ref get to five? Because I'm pretty sure that Mr. Onyx broke that hold right before five, which is well within the rules, James.
But if it wasn't illegal, the ref wouldn't have to count to begin with.
You're right.
Look at that vicious chop by Shogun, lighting up the chest of Chris Onyx. Look at this, Kenvasion, hoping that Onyx is staying on target.
Ken just provided moral support here.
Onyx is wearing a ref shirt, but if you were to take it off and move it, his chest is probably the same color as his shirt right now.
I might get to that.
Now, as you can see, Shogun slowly trying to get back to his feet. Just having his leg being worked on. But look at this. There he goes. That's hard. Smelling the blood in the water.
It looked like they were going to go for blows in a second. I was going to say, that's not something I think Chris Onyx would want to do.
And a dragon screw across that middle rope. So not only did Chris twist the knee as he was falling to the ground, but then it got wrapped around the rope as well.
This is something we've never seen Shogun before.
We've seen this before, though.
Drop kick by Chris Onyx.
What a beautiful drop kick by Chris Onyx.
And I agree with that. It is. It's a good move.
Look at this, going for the player, not hooking the leg. May have cost him a little bit.
Even though Shogun's leg is sore right now, I think the rest of him is still doing pretty decent. Onyx is going to have to do more to put Shogun down than just that.
Another thing is, Shogun needs to put some blood flowing into that leg, making sure if he can.
You see the way he's limping? Oh! Another big shot.
This is something we normally don't see of Jackson Stone. And referee Tango Jones may have to do this, but the goalie's to the face, rocking Shogun down.
Now he needs to go for the pin. Now he has Shogun days, go for the pin now.
But look at this, lifeless Shogun, but
that knee DDT. Like I said, continuously going to work on that leg, Josh. It's going to get him the victory here, ultimately.
Yes, it's
that's entirely
look at
possible.
Look at him. Greatness.
He rolls to the outside of the ring now to kind of try and give his leg a rest, for lack of a better phrase.
Greatness personified in the ring right there.
The thing is, remember at the last show, Mike, I wasn't here, but I did see that those two ended in a double countout, Butchie B and Chris Onyx. Clearly, Onyx doesn't want to have a history repeat itself.
I did.
That's a man.
Oh, look out.
Oh, hard into the rail.
And into the hardest part of the ring, which is the apron.
Yeah, no, Josh.
Oh, there we go. Yeah, give it to him.
You want to get with your ass, boy, Josh.
Give it to him.
But what kind of a man is Chris Onyx instead of Chris's kid in the way?
A smart man, James. A smart man. He's using the manager to the best of his abilities. That's what Ken is there for.
I can't argue with that because, as you can see, Onyx took the advantage right there.
Well, as I say, and Jackson now having a bum wheel.
Big dive! Look, you barely see that from Chris Onyx taking shots here to take. take out the suplex shogun.
I think this is something that Chris Onyx has to do. He has to come up with a new moveset to stay on top of Target, so that way, throw his shogun off a little bit.
Yeah, and I agree with you. Onyx also is a great up-and-comer, but he's still learning. That right there is something that I personally had not seen him do yet, but I agree with you completely, Josh. That's something that he needs to do if he wants to put away a nationally known name like Shogun.
He's in the gym training every week, working on new moves, learning stuff like this so that he can take out guys like Jackson Stone. I wanted to get back to what you were saying about the last event, Josh. Butchie being Chris, that's why we got this Pick Your Poison here. But what actually happened, I think, and I hate to say this, Ken caused a distraction that ultimately, I think, worked against Chris Onyx in that.
Well, right now, though, guys, going back to your point, Josh, Jackson is very, very slow getting up to his feet here. And you have to wonder if maybe he might be injured at this point.
I mean, the leg has been, like, very much worked on. But look at this. Shogun slowly getting back to his feet and getting back into the ring. And this, the referee Tango is in the six count. Both men are in the ring.
You can call suplex Shogun a lot of things, but a quitter is not one of them.
Okay, that's dead on. He staggers up to his feet now, but you can tell he still can't put weight on both legs. He's just wrestling the ropes.
Here comes the disrespect from Chris Onyx doing what he does best.
I mean, that's the thing about Chris Onyx. I mean, yes, he's under the guidance of Ken Bajan, but he was a bodyguard, but then he started having a big...
Decapitate him right there, Josh.
Jackson just about did with that tremendous.
Is he going to be able to run across the ring, though? Look at this.
And there goes another one.
He's still stumbling, though.
Shogun now going for a...
He's favoring that left leg.
Well, he's going for some type of suplex, but yeah, Onyx blocked it.
Onyx beast blocked the Shogun. Suplex by Shogun.
He's still got one left.
That is pretty impressive, boys. He did that on one leg.
And there goes that little screen of Shogun.
Could this be the end of Chris Onyx? Could we be about to see him get his first loss by pinfall?
If anybody could do it, Shogun could be the one, but I don't think tonight's the night, boys.
We have up for a second.
Onyx moved out of the way. Spybuster!
There's it. There it is. There's that signature.
Much to the disdain of Ken Bajan. But no, it's been a smart strategy so far in this match, guys, for Onyx to work on the leg of Jackson. You have to wonder, though, is that a game plan he came up with on his own, or do you think Ken Bajan gave him that game plan?
I think this is a cash-in plan through and through. Ken wants nothing but the best for everybody in that team.
As you can see, there's a flat shoulder yet again, but Shogun still kicked out, but this time there's a blackout.
I'm going to go back to James's last point again. This win here, Chris able to pick up a win, puts him firmly in line to get that title shot against Butchie B.
Yeah, it would be huge.
Cover!
There it is.
What?
Shogun won! That's ridiculous! Shogun out of nowhere with that mountain arrow putting away Chris Onyx, his first loss in singles competition! Shogun is proving a point of why he's the suplexing machine for a reason!
I think that was a fast count, Josh.
You gotta be kidding me!